The Trailblazer Award honors a conservative woman whose efforts and unique accomplishments have allowed other women to follow her path with greater ease. Last year's winner was Catherine Cleary. Tonight's White Women Trailblazer Award nominees are Barbara Lyons.
We have closed to a remarkable career that spanned 5 decades. Under Barbara's leadership, Wisconsin Right to Life became the premier right to life organization in the country. Barbara Lyons has not only blazed a trail for women in public policy, she has helped save countless lives. During Barbara's tenure, Wisconsin has seen abortion numbers drop by more than 73% since their age, that is less than one-third of the national abortion rate. Wisconsin Right to Life is also recognized as a national leader in efforts to preserve the right of free speech under the First Amendment, winning a number of court challenges, including a major win before the U.S. Supreme Court in 2007. Barbara Lyons is a fearless champion of the voiceless and mentor to many young conservative women. We honor her remarkable career with this nomination.
Ave
Bie has blazed the trail for women in both government and the private sector. A former chairwoman of the Public Service Commission, Ave continues leadership roles as a managing partner at the Madison office of Quarles and Brady, one of the state's largest law firms. Very few women held as many leadership roles in state government as Ave. She served as the deputy secretary at the Department of Licensing, the deputy secretary of the Department of Corrections, and a commissioner on the Public Service Commission from 1991 to 2004. Ave was chair of the PSC from 1999 to 2003. Ave serves on numerous local and national boards, including the Green Bay Active Board, United Way, Wisconsin Policy Research Institute, St. Mary's Foundation, and Arcadian Networks. Ave's energy and dedication to locals, both professional and in the community, help set the stage for younger women to work for conservative causes. Was a fitting culmination for a career that has spanned local as well as state government. She has spent more than a quarter century as an elected official, including 16 years on the Washington County Board and a decade in the State Assembly, including membership on the powerful Joint Finance Committee. Throughout her career, Pastor Strachota has had what she calls a passion for good government. When she announced her retirement earlier this year, she wrote, 10 years ago, when I ran for the 58th State Assembly District seat, the fiscal health of the state of Wisconsin was dismal. Today, thanks to the courage of the Wisconsin State Legislature and our Governor Scott Walker, we have turned the deficit into a surplus. I cannot be proud to have served during these historic times.
We have a very special guest who presents tonight's Trailblazer Award. Please welcome to the stage my mentor and the 2013 Margaret Thatcher Award winner, Wisconsin's first ever woman lieutenant governor, Margaret Barrett. Trailblazer Award goes to Barbara Lyons.
Well, I'm not usually speechless, so I won't be speechless tonight either. I'm truly humbled and honored to receive this prestigious award and greatly thank the committee for nominating and selecting me. I congratulate Chonette, Premier First Lady, who richly deserves the Margaret Thatcher Award. And Chonette, I've known Scott longer than you have, so if you didn't congratulations also to the other award winners, and I acknowledge the significant accomplishments of Representative Pat Strachota and Ave Bie. Pat is a treasured friend and colleague in our pro-life work. As a young woman raised in an Italian-American community, I appreciate the many opportunities which allow me to achieve many firsts in education and career. I was a feminist in the pure sense of the word, before it was fashionable and became distorted. How utterly empty and inhumane it is to base a woman's success today on her ability to destroy her own child. The foundation of my nomination is 40 years of work in the pro-life movement. It is a body of work which addresses the most significant human rights abuse of our times and challenges us as individuals, families, and a society to meet the needs of the most vulnerable among us. A leader cannot be successful without the support and cooperation of many. I thank my husband, my children, fellow staffers at Wisconsin Right to Life, our board members, volunteers, the members of our organization, and many people in this room who have greatly contributed to our public policy, educational, and cultural transformation successes. I am most proud in the knowledge that literally hundreds of thousands of people we encounter every day have their lives and futures because of our work. So it is a pleasure beyond imagining to accept this award as a tribute to them and as to a tribute to my colleagues at Wisconsin Right to Life. So thank you so very much. It's just an honor and a pleasure to be with you this evening. Thank you.
To follow her.